Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland, and today we're gonna do something a little bit different, not a full-on review, more of an overview type style video, because the knife we're gonna take a look at today is a full custom from Olamic Tactical, as you can see by the box on the table. And this knife was graciously loaned to me by my good friend Nico from Greece. He also has an Instagram account where he shares his high-end knife collection, so if you're interested, please check that out. You'll find a link in the description below, and the Instagram account is named Today's Grail _ Tomorrow's Beater. But now let's take a look at the knife itself. So it's an Olamic Wayfarer Compact, and you may have seen this particular knife already on YouTube, because this was actually the Wayfarer Compact that Nick Shabazz owned at one point in time. So he bought that of the secondary market, and then did also a little bit of a sneak preview on this particular knife. And you can see it is really a little bit over the top with the materials that they chose here. You have a Timascus bolster, a C-Tek inlay, which is some kind of a metal mesh that is impregnated with some resin. Just a very, very nice craftsmanship here on this knife. And this is not a regular Wayfarer. This is one of their full custom Wayfarers that they build in their shop in California. And also the price point on this is going to be quite a bit higher than on a regular Wayfarer that they offer. So let's take a look at the specs of this knife. We have an overall length of 8 1/8 inches, or 20.6 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 3 3/8 inches, or 8.6 centimeters, and a handle length of 4 6/8 inches, or 12 centimeters. The blade is made out of CTS XHP, and we have a blade thickness of 3.7 millimeters. The grind is a hollow grind, and we have this very, very gorgeous polished satin finish on there that really looks quite high-end. Just very, very nicely done here. You can also see the markings, Wayfarer Compact, which is the name of the knife right here, and CTS XHP, which is the steel. And that is certainly a great choice for a higher-end knife like this, because CTS XHP is a high-carbon, high-chromium alloyed powder steel that has a fine grain structure, excellent edge retention, good corrosion resistance, and also a quite high toughness, and still is reasonably easy to sharpen for a super steel. So nearly all the best from all the different ranges that you want a steel to perform in. So pretty nicely done here on the steel choice. I didn't use this knife very extensively. I just cut some paper to see how sharp it is, because it is not my knife and it's also quite an expensive one. But I slipped it in my pocket a couple of times and cut some paper just to get a feel for it for doing this review. But the blade is also pretty interesting. It's probably the part that is most attractive to me. A very aggressive blade here. You have some kind of a drop point with a very pronounced swetch at the top here. Then the two-tone blade with a rougher unidirectional satin on the flats, and then the more polished bevels here. This little cutout that you actually can use to open it two-handed if you need to do so in a crowded area, or just where people wouldn't be very appreciative of opening a knife like this. So that is certainly a nice little addition. And one other cool thing is the skeletonized flipper tab that I actually really like, and I would love to see that on more knives. So that is a really cool addition here. And you have a forward finger choil that also doubles as your sharpening choil, so pretty easy to sharpen there all the way to the back. And you can also use that as your forward finger choil right here. That actually works quite well for my size fingers. If you have broader or larger fingers, that may be a little bit a small choil, but for me it works perfectly, as you can see here. The thickness on the blade is pretty nice here at the tip. You can maybe do some light prying, but it's not overly thick, so pretty nice there as well. You have some good jimping here on the spine of the blade that actually is quite aggressive, so it really locks your finger in. Maybe slightly less aggressive would be nicer for extended use, but I think they executed that quite well here. But you can see it has a little bit of bite to it there. Also, the hole there is a little bit sharp on the inside, but that is certainly for additional grip when you're opening the knife in this fashion, because the detent is actually quite nicely dialed in on this knife. You can see you can flip it out no problem with this quite large flipper tab that actually would benefit from a little bit of jimping right here on the forward face of the flipper tab. But the action is actually very interesting on this Olamic Wayfarer Compact, because it's not a very loose, very false-shoddy action. You can see it falls a little bit, but then you really have to shake it in the handle. But it's not a gritty action at all. It's just a very defined, more hydraulic action, a little bit more like on a Chris Reeve or something. It feels very high-end and very controlled, but it's not as free-falling as some other knives like Shirogorov's or Chabrokovs or some other knives. But I actually really like how this knife feels when opening and closing. Another neat feature is that they actually have a detent ramp. You can see that little cutout here on the tang of the blade is actually a detent ramp, so it's very easy for the detent to slip off from the lock face and then go onto the tang of the blade. Another nice feature is that you actually have internal stop pins milled into the titanium liners here that are actually fixed onto the blade, so that makes for a very clean look here. You only have the backspacer, which is very interesting, and no external stop pin. And if you take a look at the backspacer here, you can see that intensively carved and anodized backspacer, which is one of the signature pieces of Olamic Cutlery, and they have done that here very, very nicely. And the whole concept of the knife is a little bit over the top for me personally, so I wouldn't order a knife like this just because I think the materials are too much, especially in this combination, too much going on the handle. But I certainly can appreciate the craftsmanship here. You can see I have a slightly flow-through backspacer there. And just the fit and finish here is done very remarkably. A thing that I noticed here is on the inside of that cutout, you have some brownish residue that I wasn't able to get away with a Q-tip and some oil. So maybe that is from heat treating or something, but that looks a little bit unfinished to me there. But overall, I'm quite impressed with the quality here on this custom Wayfarer Compact. You can also see that the fitting of the material is done very nicely, nearly imperceptible, nicely fitted all around. Also, the Timascus is very, very rich in color. You can also see that this one actually has a Torx pivot that is also anodized to match the Timascus there. And some of the Wayfarers have their proprietary pivot, so I actually like to see that they move to Torx screws right here. We have a little bit too many screws for my taste. You can see I have the pivot and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think that is a little bit overkill. Maybe it would look a little bit cleaner if you could do some hidden hardware or just lay it out in a different fashion. It looks a little bit crowded, especially with these very busy materials on the handle here. And you can also see here the liners are nicely fitted. And another cool thing about the liners, you can see here that the liners are very, very nicely jeweled. That is a touch that you don't see from any non-custom knife at this point, I believe. So this is really, really nice and shows some magnificent attention to detail. Very, very nicely done here. And you also have some information here on the back. You can see that this is a Wayfarer Compact with the number 221. Pretty nicely done there. Also, the markings on the blade are really classily done. I actually quite like the Olamic Tactical logo there. And you saw this marking here on this side as well. So very clean blade, and just overall the ergonomics on this knife are very impressive. It fills up the hand. You can do some work with this knife for hours on end in this very interestingly shaped handle, but it's very, very comfortable. No hot spots whatsoever, also not from the clip, which is nicely rounded and contoured but a little bit shallow. So this has also not that much of a spring tension, so the clip is a little bit of a letdown in form of function. Also, the look is a little bit splotchy with the anodizing. I don't actually like how they executed here the Timascus clip regarding the colors, and also function wise it's really not the best clip. But I believe they moved to a clip with a ceramic ball in there now, so that is certainly a better clip than this one, but it doesn't cause any kind of hotspots in the hand, so that is certainly a positive thing. Here you also have your lanyard hole, which is quite small, and I would certainly like to see removed. It takes a little bit away from the overall high-end feel of the knife. It just is a very, very basic lanyard hole, and you can also see that here around the edges it is not that nicely finished because the hole is right where one of the metal meshes meat, so that looks a little bit shoehorned in there, and that is not that nice to see on a knife of this expensive price. But overall, I have to say, very impressive knife here from Olamic Tactical. Maybe the overall design isn't something that I would pick up personally, but it certainly has some cool factor to it. And you can do a lot of different versions of the Wayfarer Compact. They have a long, long list on their website where you can choose all different materials, combinations, bolsters, no bolsters, etc., etc. And they have two steels at the moment, I think. They have CTS XHP and CTS 204P available at the moment. So both excellent steels, and the craftsmanship is certainly there, as you hopefully have seen during this overview. And thanks again to Nico for lending me this knife. Just a very, very interesting piece. You also can see that they have nicely chamfered the titanium liners here. So just a great, great knife. You can also see maybe the detent here. It's a very, very defined detent. I think it also runs on a bearing system. Hopefully you can see that here a little bit. But everything is done very nicely. Also the tolerances are quite tight. And the action is also really, really well executed. So let's do some size comparisons here. We have another custom knife that I have that I haven't done a video until now. And that is the Deviant Blades Pelican. That also sports some Timascus there. You can see that here, M390 blade. A lot different knife here, but you also have a very good looking Timascus clip. And I actually prefer this style of Timascus clip to the one on the Wayfarer here. Just looks much, much nicer in my opinion. A cool knife, it's a one-off, so really, really interesting. Timascus backspacer, and size-wise certainly in the ballpark of the Wayfarer there. And then next up, we have a knife from Kaiser, the Kaiser Mjolnir. I chose this one as a size comparison because you have a similarity in the handle here. You have this curved down handle, a little bit pistol grip style handle on the Mjolnir as well. You have M390 on the blade here, and just a much, much more understated handle here in comparison to the very busy one here of the Olamic Wayfarer. But then quality-wise, you have here a full custom. Also price-wise, this one is much, much higher. But I just wanted to show you this little comparison here. And then the last comparison I have for you is my black and white toucan from Chebukov Knives, with the gorgeous Damascus blade and the Timascus accents on the clip, the backspacer, and also the thumb stud there. Very, very gorgeous knife. And you can see that those two are actually quite similar in the overall size. So the Wayfarer is slightly longer there. And then we can take a look at the thickness, because the Wayfarer is actually quite a thick knife, as you can see here. And that is also why the ergonomics are that great. You just have a very, very hand-filling grip here. Everything is rounded and contoured. So that is certainly something that is nice in hand, but is a little bit harder to carry because you have just a bulkier knife in your pocket when you're carrying it. Also, the flipper tab here sticks out quite a bit far. Maybe if I compare that to the Mjolnir here, which is nicely cut off, and then you have some jimping at the top there. This is certainly a large flipper tab, and I also think that this is the knife that coined the term pocket packer from Nick Shabazz, so that is certainly some truth to that. Now let's take a look at the weight of it. And we have 155 grams or 5.5 ounces. And I think that is, for the size and construction of the knife, not that bad, especially because it's a much more thick knife than some other ones. Thicker blade stock and everything, so certainly quite a nice weight. But I also would love to see some skeletonized liners, but they have nicely jeweled them, so that would take away from the ornate look of it a little bit. So certainly a palatable weight here on the compact Wayfarer here in this particular layout. Maybe if you choose other materials, you can get the weight down to like 5 ounces, which would be even better. But overall, not too much to complain there. So the Olamic Wayfarer Compact in the custom version, certainly an interesting knife, and I'm also very grateful that I could handle one of these. Very ergonomic, great fit and finish. Also, the design has something to it. I wouldn't pick that up for myself, probably, especially not in this very expensive full custom version that runs you along the lines of $800. So certainly an expensive knife here, but they have done a lot of things right. on this knife, and if you like the design, I certainly wouldn't steer away from Olamic Tactical here. I don't want to do a full discussion of value here because custom knives are quite a bit different from production ones, but if you have the money, if you like custom knives, this could be a nice way to get into some high-end materials and great craftsmanship. And this was my little overview that ran quite a bit too long, but there is just so much to talk about here on this knife, so much little details that I had to cover them all. So if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please put it down in the comment section. And if you want to see more of these knife gunning gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.